All right, so Pulsar is a company that's given us gems such as the 1178. Now, added to their ever-growing library of incredible plugins is the emulation to the very famous GML 8200. Now, to test this plugin, we are going to shoot it out and get some of my favorite Masterbus EQs. Hi, welcome back. And if you're new here, my name is Fuego. If you haven't yet, please get subscribed and click the like button. The GML 8200 is a very, like I said, famous, very sought after and expensive EQ unit made by George Massenburg. Now, this is the Pulsar 8200 emulation with features not found in the original box. So let's check it out. So it's got features such as the air tilt in the sub. So usually on my mix bus or master bus, I have this BrainWorks BX1. I have this parallel EQ, which this is also a parallel EQ as well. So I have this parallel EQ, Clarifonics. I have this, the Poltec, and I have this other EQ, one of my favorite, the Curve Bender. So first, what I want to do is kind of emulate these two curves over here. All right. So I'm going to play something and we're going to try to bring these mono and stereo curves over to this and see what it sounds like. These are just the sides, so they got everything on one kind of like on one display. So you okay, so my other EQ, this one's got two displays, one for mono and one for stereo, or mid side, whatever. And we're gonna take down some. Alright, so when you're working on mono or stereo, it just switches. Instead of having all the EQ, all the nodes from both mono and stereo on one display, it just switches and show you just the nodes that you're working with in mono. Cool, I like it. What else we got? Thank you. I'm just gonna wait a second. All right, so I'm gonna have this bypass. I just realized I had it not bypass. So we're gonna do a proper before and after. So here's before. This one, but what I really like about this one, what I feel like they could have added in the Pulsar is because we have tons of space, I would say, to add something such as stereo width and maybe a mono maker. Okay, it does have the DSR, which on here is you can use as a, so you have this dynamic EQ section where you could use it as a DSR if you like. In the George almost says George Massenburg, and the Pulsar 200 also has a DSR section as well, which is very cool. So, as you can see, this I use just for cutting and fixing, make sure that my mono is set. You know, my lows are monoized. I use this for all of that, also to enhance the stereo field of the song as well. But for boosting, I usually use the curve bender and the Pultec and clarifonics. So we're not gonna be doing a shootout between all these three. We're just gonna. I just wanted to see how it stacks up against this for cutting. But for boosting, we are going to do some boosting and see what it sounds like. A lot of what this plugin was famous for is the fact that it sounds so beautiful. It sounds so musical when boosting as well. So it does have the oversampling. So I'm just going to engage times 8 or something else below here. Where are we? Okay, so that's why I want it to stay. There you go. Okay, same as real time, or you could do offline oversampling. All right, and while we're doing this, because you can do this on this plugin, you can resize it. So let's bring it to make it bigger. All right, so for boosting. For boosting, I'm doing broad strokes because at this point, you know, when you are at this stage doing master bus processing, you don't want to do narrow cued boosting. So therefore, if we're doing, you know, really broad strokes or, you know, broad IQ boosts. So 15 dBs is the most you could boost on this EQ. Make sure I have this off. Two times. All right, so before, what just happened? I feel like there are a few more features that they could have added in the plugin emulation, but nonetheless, this has been the Pulsar 8200, and I've been Fuego. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell notification icon that you don't miss any of these great tips on how to get your mix all the way up to par with the pros. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.